What's it like?
What?
Be alive.
Maybe you'll find out.
9 days about life and our connection and relationship with life. It's very, I think, metaphysical somehow, but also grounded in your perspectives of an individual, as a person that the only person that can be you is you.
It's about a guy who lives by himself in a house in the middle of nowhere. And in his living room, he has 30 CRT televisions, like 1980s style televisions, and on each one is somebody's life. He's taking meticulous notes, he's recording bits of it on VHS tapes, and then he's methodically filing it away. And one day, one of the lives that he follows very closely, that person dies unexpectedly. The TV turns off, and within the next 24 hours, applicants show up at his doorstep to be interviewed to hopefully fill that void on the television.
Hi.
Hi.
Please, come in.
Well, Will's realm, as I like to call it, you know, we don't know exactly where it is. It's not Earth. It's not our reality. So suddenly it's like, oh, we can do something very different with this.
It's a house in the desert. It's surrealistic. But at the same time, the elements that creates this environment, they're very grounded. It's just a house. And it's a desert. It was important to have the feeling like, okay, this is a place that could exist. Doesn't exist, but could. In terms of sound, for me, it was the same. It shouldn't be anything that I'm creating out of from nowhere. We can see like, oh, I know those sounds, I know this reality, but showing in a way that we never heard or seen before.
I like to read the material and see the dailies to get the thing as soon as I can. And I like to build and to record a lot of material before I have the film. How I like to work is doing a palette of sounds, as if I'm a painter and I'm gonna choose the colors before I do it. When I have so much material and I have the film in front of me, I start painting on the film, experimenting and seeing, no, now the story, oh, this is taking the story exactly to where it has to go. Now I have a counterpoint that is making it more beautiful.
There's so much to explore and create in terms of the texture, in terms of language, in terms of what they experience. Sometimes they're in the park, sometimes they're talking with friends, sometimes they're, you know, kissing people.
Se despedem ao passar e na vida que sonhavas nessa terra inicial.
Seeing the film the first time, to be honest, was a little daunting with the whole concept with the TVs, the 30 televisions. There are going to be people's lives in North America, Central America, and South America, and we had to help convey that through sound. It's like, how on earth are we going to do this?
The project is, it's incredibly complicated because of all the TVs. We had to immediately kind of create like the rules of the film and what you hear, when you hear it, and why you hear it. When we're in the house, it's a little more one-dimensional. It's a little flat. We're using speaker placement as part of that rule. So, you know, ambiences and everything are kind of stuck to the screen. We're not actually using the surrounds that much. And then when we go into these worlds, we can actually open up and actually have, you know, the technicolor, the life. Sound is popping off from every speaker around the room. We actually have a map of the house. So we actually know where everything is when you walk around the house and where you're at. There's a lot of math involved just to figure that mapping out.
So when Will doesn't pick a soul, he gives that person the opportunity to write down one moment.
What should I do now?
Just watch them. And anything you like, write it down.
They actually get to choose something they've seen. Could be going to the beach, you know, feeling the sand. It could be riding through town in Brazil.
They put headphones on and they become fully immersed. And this is like truly a really amazing POV moment. Sound designers and re-recording mixers and supervisors always sort of beg directors for those POV moments where we can really get in the character's head. And these are absolutely those kinds of moments, especially on Mike's recreation of the beach scene. It's a really well-crafted scene, especially from the mix standpoint, from what Brandon's doing, where it starts very quietly. You hear all the details of Mike's feet walking in the sand. It's a very sort of close-up shot. Edson wanted to hear every grain of sand. And then once we get into full beach ocean mode, we really take the format of Dolby Atmos to full advantage. You hear seagulls, you hear waves, you hear kids on the beach, and then it all just gets sucked away. Very dramatic because we haven't done a lot of that up to that point. So suddenly there's this huge contrast of like, whoa, this movie is something else.
I never thought that I thought about sound, but maybe because it was giving so much attention to the emotions, which is the most important thing. And as we all know, sound is emotion. I wasn't aware like that it could be that amazing and so emotional and personal. And I think Atmos is just perfect. I'm so lucky and grateful to have this the chance to explore this tool, which is pretty new for me.